First of all, I want to thank you so much for inviting us in, welcoming us. We're so honored to be here. And yeah, we're really looking forward to what God is going to do today. Let's just be let's just be aware of His presence right now. Let's just take a moment and let's just be aware of that God, the God of the universe, is inside of us and He's in the room. Like, let's just close our eyes and let's just focus on Him for a minute. Yeah, thank you, Father. Thank you for fathering us. Thank you, Jesus. You are so beautiful. You are so beautiful, God. You are so beautiful. Yes. We didn't deserve to be with you, and yet you want us to be with you. Yeah. Let's just worship Him for a second. Oh, we worship you. Oh, you are so beautiful. So beautiful. You can use your own words, you can speak in tongues, whatever you want. Just set your affection on Him. You are worthy, you are worthy, you are worthy. Doesn't even matter what kind of words you're saying, He's seeing your heart. He's seeing your heart. You are worthy. So da 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 shila la katora. You are worthy, you are worthy, you are worthy, you are worthy. You are worthy. Yes, yes, thank you, God. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for speaking through us. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for... He is so excited. I can feel His excitement for this morning. This is not just going to be another service. This is going to be a meeting with the Holy Spirit. This is going to be freedom. He is going to do something new in your heart. Do you believe it? Do you believe He can do something new in your heart? Raise your expectations. Raise your expectations. He's going to do it. He's going to do it. You're going to leave this place with a greater love, a bigger love for Him, because He loves to reveal Himself to Him. He loves to reveal Himself to Him. He's going to show you a new side of His face, and that can be different for everyone.
Hi, Church. Good morning. Good morning. Come on, you can do better than that. Good morning. You must be wondering what's happening, right? When we look at the Bible, when we look at prophecy, it's to build, to edify, to comfort people. And because God loves this church so much, we wanted to release what God wants to do in this church. And when we are prophesying over people, over your church, they are part of your family, they're your body parts. So when they're prophesying over someone, they're actually prophesying over your body. You get what I'm saying? Can we just take some time to be aware of His presence? Yeah? Just close your eyes. Just lift up your hands. Just lift it high. Just step out of your comfort zone. Can you just say, Jesus? Keep calling out His name. Say, Jesus. Sweet Jesus. Sweet Jesus. Sweet Jesus. Sweet Jesus. Can we all stand up? I want you to lift up your own song, your heart song, what is inside of you. I want you to lift it up. Come on. Yeah. Just don't hold anything back. Give him your everything because he deserves everything.
Ooh, we love you, we love you.
Yeah, lift it up, church. Come on, from the back to the front. Everybody. It doesn't matter how skilled you are. It doesn't matter if you have a singer's voice or not. To him, your heart matters.
Yeah, sing out in the spirit. Come on, church. Lift it up. I want to hear it. Come on.
Of my life was God brought me back to his heart through worship. Worship is not a bunch of songs and lyrics. It's your life. It's your life. Out of the brokenness of your heart, what comes out is worship. Even if it's just a sound, to the Lord it's worship. Even if it's just a teardrop, it's worship to him. So what you have inside of you, I want you to give it to him. Whatever it is, if you are disappointed today, if you are angry with God today, just give your heart to him. That is worship to him. Because he deserves it. He deserves it. Just come out of your shame. Come out of your dignity. Just give him everything because he is my everything. Don't look at the person standing next to you. Just look at him. Set your eyes on 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 him. You know, people ask us why we're so wild, why we're so crazy. It's because of his grace. If you hear our stories, each one of our stories, when everything turned aside from us, when everyone rejected us, there was a love that pulled us closer. And was his love. I grew up in church. I'm a pastor's daughter. But just because I grew up in church and I was a pastor's daughter, I didn't know the Father. I was addicted to pornography. I was addicted to masturbation. God set me completely free. That's when I knew there's a Father that's pulling me closer. If I grew up in the Old Testament, I deserve death.
I deserve to be stoned. But there's a man named Jesus that took my death, that took my shame, that took my pain, so that I can stand here and give him glory in freedom. So how can I be quiet when he set me completely free? What is your story today? Why couldn't David keep quiet, even though he was a king? Love never keeps silent. Love is never quiet. He gave it all up for you. I believe there are people in the room who want to give their lives to Jesus. And I believe there are people in the room who want to rededicate their lives to Jesus. And if you feel like, continue playing. If you feel like, I want a deeper relationship with Jesus, I've turned away a little bit, I've gone and do my own life, I've lived with the knowledge of him, I went to service every Sunday, I prayed. There's much more than that. Jesus wants a love relationship with you. He doesn't want you to just do things for him. He wants to know you, and he wants you to know him. He wants this personal, face-to-face relationship, this daily walk with you. And it starts with receiving his love. It starts with receiving his love, accepting his love. If you feel like you're not worthy of his love, you're not accepting his love. You're not accepting what he did on the cross. You're actually rejecting his love. But he died for you, not for you to reject his love. He died for you so he can freely give all his love. He doesn't just want to give you a little portion. He wants to bestow it on you like a waterfall, like you even can't contain it anymore, because he loves you so much. But he wants to give it to you. And so if you want that relationship, if you want him as your lover in your life, if you want him as his master, as the master in your life, the king in your life, I want you to raise your hand. If you want to rededicate your life to him. Yeah, I just want to remind you that you are sons and daughters of God. If you accepted Jesus in your life, you're sons and daughters of God. And from this relationship with you, you get to walk in power. You get to walk in authority. You get to bring heaven to earth. It's such a privilege to be his sons and daughters. And so I bless you with that. I bless you with purpose. I pray that the Holy Spirit will show you the purpose for your life. And I bless you with a confidence that you are the son and daughter of God, and that you can come before his throne boldly to receive grace whenever you need it. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. We're going to close this moment. We're going to transition into the word. Isaac's going to share the word. But it doesn't mean, you can you can still keep receiving. Even when you're listening, we're transitioning. Keep your heart in that receiving posture. Yeah. Thank you, God, for what you're doing. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Can we just give Jesus a shout? He's so good. He's so good. Wow. Amazing. I did not expect that was going to happen right now. That wasn't part of the plans, but when God crashes the party, it's, you know, we'll go with his plans. It's such an honor to be here today. And first, I just want to honor the pastors and the fathers and mothers of this house. Thank you guys for having us. Such an honor to be here. Thank you guys. Oh, I think what just happened here goes very well with what we were feeling with the team and what we were thinking about God was doing. And it might have looked like it was like opposite. We almost like did the altar call first and then now we're going into the sermon. But I truly believe that was God setting us up for what he has. Because what I want to talk about today is the Father's love and the freedom that he brings as a son and daughter of a king. My name is Isaac Hernandez, by the way. I'm from the United States. I am Mexican-American. I know I look Indian, but I'm Mexican. Malaysia has been amazing. The people of Malaysia, I've never been received in a country so well. You guys' hearts are, blows my mind. Just servants, I'm just like, man, I've learned so much as being here. Like, I felt I've received so much more than what I've gave out because you guys have just overwhelmed us with our love. And my whole team can testify to that, that the people of Malaysia carry such beautiful hearts. So thank you guys all. But Malaysia has been amazing. What we have seen in these past 12 days has been crazy. Like, revival is happening here in Malaysia. Revival is happening here in this church. And it's what revival is becoming aware of God's presence. And right now, people are waking up to what God is doing. The move of God here in Malaysia, the move of God here in this church with the Father of this house, with what he's doing here. People are coming awake of God's presence. We have seen many salvations since we've been here. And it's not about Bethel. It's not about me. It's about what God is already doing here. We have seen over 400 people saved. Hindus, Muslims, Buddhists, atheists saved. Radical healings. And I believe God, even right now, God is healing people in this room at this very moment. In this moment, God is healing. He's bringing freedom. He's bringing freedom to you right now. I've never seen anything like it, guys. And I want you guys to raise up your expectations because what God is doing right now in this church, right here, right now, and what he's doing in your life is something I've never seen before. And I just want to share a little bit of my story. It's a prodigal son story. Where I ran away from the Father my entire life. I was fatherless. I didn't have my Heavenly Father. I couldn't understand it. I was demonically oppressed. And my entire life, I couldn't learn. The stories of the Bible, I didn't understand them. My parents would take me to church and I was like, I don't want nothing to do with that. Because the church that I was involved, like, all they were teaching was like religion, and they weren't teaching about relationship with Jesus. And as a true Christian, relationship with the Father and with Jesus and Holy Spirit is everything. I didn't feel like a son. I felt like I was an orphan. I felt like I had nothing going for me. My entire life, I'm 29 years old now, but for 24 years of my life, I felt like there's no future. I didn't dream. I didn't have a future. I started drinking at the age of 12. Because why even try in life if you have no hope? And how many of you guys know that the only hope is in Jesus? Until Jesus came into my life, there was no hope. I had no dreams. But the Father never gave up on me. He chased me down with everything that he had. As I was drinking, chasing after women, I wasn't a good guy. Treated women badly, devalued them, wanted to do whatever I wanted. I was really depressed as well. I was like a slave to my own self because I didn't want the world to see who I was, because I felt like it wasn't good enough for the world. So it was all performance. I acted a certain way with this person. I acted a certain way with this person. Nobody knew the true me. On the outside, it looked like I had everything going for me. I made the outside look good, but the inside, it was just depression, loneliness. I drank my life away. I worked at a hospital, and I would be drunk at a hospital. Thank God that nothing happened. But the Father's heart burned to have me. He burned to have me. No matter what I was doing, he burned to have me. And he burns to have you. For 24 years of my life, I felt like I had nothing. But it came one day where freedom kind of finally came to my life, where finally I was open to accept him. I was in the bathroom by myself, and my parents, they prayed for me constantly. They never gave up on me. And God was so relentless in his love that when I got saved, I was by myself. It was in the darkest time of my life, and I was getting ready to go out. And I was in the bathroom, and I had this radio station playing, a non-Christian radio station. And this Christian song comes on in Spanish, but I don't even really listen to Spanish music. I speak Spanish, by the way. So it comes on, and what the words say, even though I can't see you, I can feel you. My entire life, I wondered if Jesus was actually real. I was like, could this man 2,000 years ago actually be real? That was my thought my entire life. But in this song, it was describing him so real. It said, even though I can't see you, I can feel you. Even though I can't touch you, my heart can feel you. And it was at that very moment where I felt God just come over my life and enter into my heart and fill me with this love that I had never felt before, with this freedom that I had been looking for my entire life. I never cried back then, and I am bawling like a baby, and I'm on my knees, and I'm like, God, I'm not much, but I'll give you all that I am from this day forward. And I said, Jesus, I know this is you. It was undeniable, undeniable. I knew it was Jesus coming in and changing my life. And that's when freedom came into my life. Freedom to be me. The identity that I had was from him, was from the Father. It wasn't all these masks and all these lies that the devil tries to put. But God came and started ripping these lies out of me. His love was so great. And that's the same freedom that I believe that God has brought into this room and is going to continue to be released throughout this night, throughout this day. God burns to have you. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. God gave everything to have you. He literally gave everything to have you. I feel like we need to understand how big that is, how important that is. We can't go past that. That like, if you right there in the orange shirt were the only one that was on this planet, he still would have came down and died for you. If you were the only one, and that goes for everybody in this room. If you were the only one on this planet, God would have came down and died for you. When Jesus died on that cross, he was looking right at you. He was looking right at your eyes. And he says, "Son and daughters, come to me. I did this for you, broken and bloody for you, to bring freedom, to bring healing." God has transformed my life. It's been 4.5 years. And these 4.5 years have been the best 4 years of my life. I finally have dreams. He has given a vision for my life. But it's all about him. You have to make it all about Jesus first and foremost. Seek him with everything that you got. And everything that you want in life is just going to come right to you. Signs and wonders will follow all of that. Lord of my life, making him your everything. You guys are all chosen and set apart. God has a special and unique plan for each and every one of you, just like he has it for me. And if he can change my life, he can change your life. He can bring freedom to my life, he can bring freedom to your life. My identity is not in partying anymore. My identity is not even in myself anymore. My identity is in Jesus. When I look into his eyes, when I get alone with him, that's when I know who I am. When I look into his eyes, I can see the reflection in myself. And that's when I know who I am. But it's only going to him first. If you don't go to Jesus first, then how do you know what you're supposed to do here in this world? It's only through him that shows you. For it is by grace you have been saved, through faith, and this is not from yourselves. It is the gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast. For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus, to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. We are God's handiwork. I love that. Each and every one of you is an art piece from God. Never look down on yourselves. Because if you look down on yourself, you're saying that what God created wasn't good. And when he made you, he said, "You are good." He is not ashamed of you. He says, "When I made you with a purpose and a calling." But now it's coming a time in your life where now it's like it's time to believe it. It's time to believe what he has made for you and what he has waiting for you. It's out of that love response that God has loved us first, that we go and share what he has done for us. that we go and tell the world what he has done. I'm here right now, sitting here today, because of the love that he poured out over me. I'm not even from this country. I'm not even supposed to be here. I felt unqualified to be here, to be honest with you. But he qualified me. It's his strength, not mine. But I can't do it on my own. I have to depend on him. If I'm not fully dependent on him, first and foremost, I cannot be on this stage. And even right now, I feel unqualified. But I even hear him saying, like, Isaac, I am the great I am who lives inside of you. So everywhere you go is holy ground. Just like Moses on the burning bush, like he went to the burning bush and God said, take your sandals off. You're standing on holy ground. And God told Moses to go free a whole nation. He felt unqualified to go. He said, who am I? And I feel like there's a lot of people in this room that are saying, who am I? I feel like there's dreams and visions and desires in your heart that God has spoken over you. That you felt you weren't good enough. But I just want to remind somebody here, and want to remind all of you today, that when you are a son and daughter of a king, that you're capable to do the impossible because of him. And I saw a vision this year of that same burning bush that Moses encountered. That same burning bush coming inside of me, coming inside of all his people, coming inside all his sons and daughters. And wherever you walk is holy ground. To know that wherever you go, wherever he sends you, that he is with you. To have the identity of Christ, to have the boldness, to know who's backing you, to know that it's not you, it's him. I see a lot of greatness in this room. But I feel like there's people that feel like they're not worthy enough to have this calling or not good enough to have this. But God is telling you today that it is that great I am that lives inside of you. And he wants to continue to show you that and pour it out over you. And he wants to continue to bring freedom. We're going to go to Peter 2:9. But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who I called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. Once you were not a people, but now you are the people of God. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy. I can say it again. But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a holy nation. Some of you guys just need to receive it. Can you guys just put your hands out like this and just receive the truth over your life being spoken over you? This is who you are. This is who you are as a people. God will bring the boldness. God will bring everything that you need. But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession. That you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. Once you were not a people, but now you are a people of God. Once you have not received mercy, but now you have received mercy. It's all about Jesus. It's not about me. It's not about me. It's not about Bethel. Can I have everybody stand up? We're just going to declare, united as one people, Because there have been people in this room that have given their lives to Christ. Let's unite together as one nation. Under one kingdom, under one king, under one Father. We're just going to declare it, that He is King. So everybody together, I really feel like there's freedom just coming in right now. There's like hope coming into your hearts right now. There's freedom and hope coming into your hearts right now. Trust me, guys, 2 years ago, I could not be up here. What are the things that He's calling you to do? So right now, as a declaration, we're going to count to three. And I want everybody to yell, Jesus, with everything that you got, because He's worthy. He is worthy. What He paid for on that cross, He's worthy. He died to bring you freedom. By His stripes, you are healed. And even right now, later on, we're going to check. People just start checking your bodies. But on the count of three, we're just going to go after it. And we're going to break. Chains are being broken off today. The enemy is not going to have a stronghold on you anymore. Those chains are being broken off today. You're going to walk out of here a different person. If you can do it in my life, you can do it in your life. Yeah, so right now, in the count of three, we're just going to bring invite freedom into this room. And chains are falling today. So in three, with everything that you got, two, He's worthy. One, Jesus! Like there's more. There's more. Like, how many of you know that in the kingdom of God, there's always more? There's always more. He always has more for you. I know we can do better than that. I've seen Malaysia. I know the people. I know you guys can do better than that. He's so worthy. Don't look at me. Just look straight up and look at Him. He's right here in this room right now. I can just sense the angels. The throne room of God is right in this room right here right now. Just like the elders bowing down, giving them everything. Give them all that you got. With every cell, every bone in your bodies, give it all to Him. So let's do this again. Chains are being broken right now, guys. Come on. Three, Jesus, come on. Two, come on. One, Jesus! Wow. Thank you, Father, for your Shekinah glory coming into this place today. Thank you for marking us today, God. I pray that you mark your people, your holy nation, your true sons and daughters. Lord, I pray a blessing over them right now in Jesus' name. And God, just everything you've given unto me, I fully release it over to them right now in Jesus' name. And I just even feel like God is saying, start checking your bodies because people are being healed right now. Start waving your hands in the air if you feel a difference. If you feel a difference in your body, start waving your hands in the air. Wow, thank you, Jesus. Wow. Thank you, God, for what you're doing. Yeah. Go in peace. Go knowing that there's a roaring lion going behind you, protecting you everywhere you go. He'll never leave you. I bless you all in Jesus' name. Amen.